And very specifically, it had themes, but it didn't have a narrative that continued from day to day like many comic strips did. So Peanuts was very simple drawing, so it could be written very small, and it had a very strong rhythm. Instead of ending with a slapstick explosion, it was four beats, like one, two, four. And the fourth beat was almost like a sigh. Not an explosion or a laugh. So I liked Peanuts very much when I was a little kid, but by the time I was an adult, I wasn't as interested in that anymore, because Peanuts was used to tell you that happiness is a warm puppy, it was used to sell cars and insurance. I wasn't so interested. But some of the younger cartoons I knew, really the only comics culture that moved them was Peanuts, and it made me look at it again. So when I got a letter from Charles Schulz inviting me, if I ever was out I went to number one snooping place as soon as I found out that it was not a joke. And then I began to make an essay for the New Yorker about Peanuts, right before he stopped doing it, it turned out. I didn't know that at the beginning of his out. And it was an essay about Peanuts in the form of a Peanuts comic that included quotations by Umberto Eco about his take on Peanuts and things like that. I can't read you the whole thing. It was a three-page strip, and I had many points. Thank you.